Hello, my dear students. Now this is the second video lesson. In the last video lesson, we studied what is meant by biology, that is the study of living organisms. Next, cell, the basic unit of life. Cell is the structural and functional unit of all living organisms. Next, a wall of bricks was taken as an example to understand how the body of plants and animal is made of. So it is made up of a number of cells. So there we observed cork cells, onion peel cells, cheek cells. Next, ground plan of the plant cell also we studied. That consists of cell wall, cellulose cell wall, cell membrane, cytoplasm, a very big permanent vacuole, nucleus, chloroplast, mitochondria, and also we studied the plant cell anatomy, where also we observed cell wall, plasma membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus, a very big vacuole, chloroplast, Golgi complex, mitochondria, lysosomes, like that. So then also how to divide the plant cell we studied, that is cell wall and protoplast, protoplast into cell membrane, protoplasm, protoplasm into cytoplasm and nucleus. Cytoplasm consists of water, mineral nutrients and different kinds of organelles. So today we are going to study what is meant by an animal cell. See, all animals, even the protozoans, they comes under protista. They all consists of basic structural and functional units called cells. If you see here amoeba, this amoeba is a single cell, though here it has so many pseudopodia, there it is a actually swallowing some other microorganisms. So that is also a cell. It is also a structural and functional unit. It is performing all kinds of functions as the biggest body of a whale or any elephant perform. So respiration, digestion, excretion, ingestion of food. It's like so many metabolic activities are going on. So then if you take one elephant, this also consists of cells, same kind of cells, though their shapes and functions may vary. Billions of cells, crores of cells constitute an animal, an elephant, a whale fish. So this function of one cell is actually shown in the overall function of the body of an animal. So every animal body is also consists of cells. If you take your favorite animal panda, this panda is also nothing but an aggregation of a group of an organization of millions and billions of cells. Every organ has so many tissues, so many cells. If you take lion, this is also, the entire body is made up of similar kind of cells what we studied in amoeba, what we are going to study in the next slide. So this lion is also consists of number of millions of cells. This cow also, this deer also, all animals, even human beings, we are also an aggregation of a group of cells. Manam enti oka kanala samuhamu. So every animal is not made up of anything else other than cells. See here, we will study what is the structure of the cell, what are the different parts are there in the cell. The cell is a basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms. So here I have put numbers. So if we go according to those numbers, we can understand the cell very well, from outermost part to the innermost part. So first of all, so it is a spherical in shape. It exists in different forms, different shapes, different sizes are available. That video will be seen in the next videos. So first of all, in a plant cell we saw cell wall. The outermost layer was a cell wall, but here you see the outermost layer is plasma membrane. Here cell wall is not present, cell wall is absent. So it is a characteristic feature of animal cells. Animal cells do not consist of cell walls. Outermost layer is a plasma membrane. That's why when we touch the animal body or human body, we get this smooth sensation of a smoothness. If you touch a plant, you get a sensation of a hardness. Reason, plants are made up of cells with cell walls, whereas animals are made up of cells without cell walls. That's why they are smooth to touch. So outermost layer is plasma membrane. Inner to the plasma membrane, as we studied in plant cells, cytoplasm is there, a jelly like substance. Jiguruga unde padarthamu, a jelly like substance which consists of lot of water, minerals, proteins, carbohydrates, fats like that. So cytoplasm is the second part of the cell. So inner outermost part is plasma membrane, that is one. Second one is cytoplasm. So next one I would like to describe, this is a third part, nucleus. See the nucleus. In plant cell, nucleus is smaller, whereas vacuole is very larger. Whereas in the case of animal cell, nucleus occupies a prominent place in the cell. Though it is the headquarters of the cell, dynamic center of the cell in both plant and animal cells. So here, all present, future, past, all aspects of the cell, the history of the cell, the future of the cell is in the coded form, that is in DNA. So second one, in the nucleus we can find a small spherical structure that we call as nucleolus. So within the nucleus, nucleoplasm will be there. In that a network is there, you see, this a network like substance that consists of DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. So we call that colored the fine thread like structure as a chromatin or chromatin reticulum, that is actually going to be modified into chromosomes, and that chromosome consists of DNA. So those things we will study in higher classes. So nucleus, nucleolus and chromatin, these are the parts of the nucleus. So we have studied plasma membrane, inner to plasma membrane cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, a very big nucleus is present in any animal cell. So next one is, around this nucleus you can find a network of tubular vesicular structures are present. You see, this same thing we studied in a plant cell also. We call it as a endoplasmic reticulum. Here number 6 is written as typed as rough endoplasmic reticulum, because it consists of some particles, you see. So red dots are there. Those we call as ribosomes. So ribosomes are meant for a production of proteins. From where we get proteins? We get proteins from ribosomes. Whether it is a plant or a bacterium or a fungus or a human being, proteins are produced by tiny organelles called ribosomes. So we studied different parts so far. First, outermost is plasma membrane, inner to plasma membrane cytoplasm is present. Then a very big nucleus is there with a nucleolar cell chromatin, rough endoplasmic reticulum with ribosomes we have studied. So next one we can see smooth endoplasmic. Some part of the endoplasmic reticulum may be smooth, so we call it a smooth endoplasmic reticulum because it does not consist of ribosomes. Its function is not synthesis of proteins, but its function is production of lipids and sterols. Lipids and fats, oils, manaku fats, oils we get from this smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So next part is, that is a Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus, we saw these Golgi apparatus in plant cell also. So I told that Golgi apparatus is a main function is secretion of substances for during cell division, and also it is useful in fertilization of sperm with the egg. So those things we will study later. So ninth part is Golgi apparatus. First part is plasma membrane, second cytoplasm, three nucleus, nucleolus, chromatin, and sixth part rough endoplasmic reticulum, seventh part ribosomes, eighth part smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and ninth part Golgi complex. We will see which, what is the tenth part. So here this lysosome, we studied this lysosome in plant cell also. It is for digestion. If any food particle enters the cell, that particle is digested and further converted into smaller molecules by lysosome, because this consists of so many digestive enzymes. So genome kavadaniki lysosomes chala useful avutayi. So next part is so we have studied plasma membrane, that is a semi permeable membrane, that is outermost layer, cytoplasm, jelly like substance, nucleus, the dynamic center of the cell, endoplasmic reticulum for production of proteins, lipids, and for transport. And next one is a Golgi complex for secretion of substances, and lysosomes. So 11th part, you can see very very important part, that is mitochondria, that decides the age of the cell, that decides the appearance of your body, the facial appearance, your personality, your age, your activeness, that is decided by the health of the mitochondria and the number of mitochondria. So as much as you live in pure air conditions, oxygenated conditions, so your mitochondria will be healthier and plenty in number, and your age will be more, and your personality will be charming personality. So mitochondria, don't take it underestimate, it is very very important part that produces ATP energy. ATP means adenosine triphosphate energy, that we will study later. So mitochondria is also one of the most important part. Next part I would like to explain is, that is a cytoskeleton, that consists of microtubule, microfilament, so here intermediate filament, Tolbi, Toldi, Tolci, these three are constitutes cytoskeleton that gives a shape to the cell. Centrosome, finally the most characteristic important and characteristic feature of all animal cells is present of this centrosome. This centrosome is present in animal cell but absent in plant cells. So very very important part. So that is useful in cell division. So one cell divides into two, so during that process, so overall description we can one time we can recapitulate. So animal cell consists of plasma membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus, and next one endoplasmic reticulum, seventh part you see ribosomes, eighth part smooth endoplasmic reticulum, ninth part Golgi apparatus, tenth part lysosomes, 11th part mitochondria, 12A microfilament, 12B microtubule, 12C intermediate filament, 12D centrosomes. So animal cell consists of different parts. So this drawing you have to draw after watching this video. So here I would like to show the differences between a plant cell and animal cell, very important aspect. So what are the features of a plant cell? What are the features of an animal cell? So that we have already discussed as a recapitulation, as a part of recapitulation, as a part of, you can call, revision. So you can see the appearance of a plant's animal cell. So we have already discussed animal cell consists of cell wall, and that is hard from the outside. Animal cell does not consist of plasma membrane. Let us see how it would be. So I have shown you three important parts here. A red ringed three parts. One is cell wall. Second one is a central vacuole. Third one, chloroplast. The characteristic features of any plant cell. So the outermost layer of the plant cell is cell wall. It consists of cellulose cell wall. This cell wall is absent in animal cells. Present in plant cell and absent in animal cell. Second one, you see a very large central vacuole is there. In the case of animal cell, a small vacuole is present. But it may be absent. But in the case of plant cell, a large central vacuole is present. That is a characteristic feature of a plant cell. Third one is chloroplast, photosynthetic organelle that performs photosynthesis, that converts sunlight, carbon dioxide and water into carbohydrates, into our food. The food for the entire animal and plant kingdom is supplied by this chloroplast. So, three important characteristic features are there. One is cell wall, central vacuole, chloroplast. Again, I am telling you, cell wall is present in plant cell, absent in animal cell. Central vacuole is a large central vacuole is present in plant cell, absent in animal cell. Chloroplast is present in plant cell and absent in animal cell. Next one, so what is the characteristic feature of an animal cell is, it does not consist of cell wall, large vacuole and chloroplast. Animal cell consists of centrosome only. Centrosome is absent in plant cells. Centrosome is present in animal cells. You should not forget this. So very important question in 8th class and 9th class and intermediate. If you take BIPC in intermediate, this is an important question. So overall what we have learned today, the cell consists of, plant cell consists of cell wall, a large central vacuole, chloroplast, whereas animal cell consists of a centrosome, but not these three parts. Other parts are common in both plant cell and animal cell. So next one, I will show you how to draw the diagram of a plant cell. Dear students, here you can see how to draw an animal cell. First, I have drawn the outermost layer, that is plasma membrane. Second one is I am drawing a nucleus with a nuclear covering and surrounded by endoplasmic reticulum. This part is indicates endoplasmic reticulum, that is a network like structure. So next one, so that black dots what I am putting there, that is a indication of ribosomes. So we can consider this as rough endoplasmic reticulum. So here also freely available ribosomes I am showing in cytoplasm. So I have completing the nuclear covering. So next one is, here I am drawing a Golgi complex. So that is secretory organelle. So in the nucleus I am showing a nucleolus and a chromatin reticulum. So here you can find mitochondria. Next one is centrosome. These are lysosomes. microtubules, microfilaments, intermediate filaments. So one small vacuole is also there. So this yellow dots indicate a jelly-like substance, that is a cytoplasm in the plant cell. Likewise, you can draw, and now labeling, first cell membrane, cytoplasm, then nucleus, nucleolus, chromatin reticulum, Golgi complex, mitochondria, centrosome, lysosomes, microtubule, microfilament, intermediate filament, ribosomes, freely available ribosomes, small vacuole. So this is animal cell. So I suggest you, after watching the video, I have given a link, their animal cell drawing is there, that you draw in your notebook. After that, you write down a brief introductory notes on animal cell and what are the differences between plants and animal cell. But don't forget to write comments. So at the bottom of this video on YouTube, in the blog where you find the notes, at the bottom of that blog and in the Google Classroom also, you have comments box. You write your doubts or your feedback in those comments. That would be helpful to me to create a still further improved videos in future. Thanking you.